Welcome back to Star Wars Celebration Live 2015, powered by Verizon on StarWars.com. I am joined now by Doug Chang, the Vice President and Executive Creative Director of Lucasfilm, and Christian Alsman, the Senior Art Director of Industrial Light and Magic. Between the two of y'all, you've made some real pretty movies.
Oh, yeah.
Some real pretty movies.
Yeah. It's a lot of work.
Yeah. We have a lot of fun at work.
Yeah, I believe it. And, you know, obviously, now that the Force Awakens teaser has come out, people are beginning to see more and more of your work from the film. I have to wonder, you know, you're coming back to a world that the two of you have visited before. It's a world with its own design language. It's got its own visual style already, and it has for 30 years. But you're also trying to make something new.
Yeah.
How do you approach that? What goes through your head? How much do you change?
Yeah. No, I mean, for me, it's actually a lot of fun because when I started working with George, I was all primed to do Joe Johnson and Ralph McQuarrie drawings. Mm-hmm. And so now I finally have a chance to do that because we're kind of bridging off of their aesthetics. Mm-hmm. And so really, it's kind of like going back to my childhood when I was 15, where when I first saw the movie, I wanted to do those drawings.
Yeah.
And now I get to do it. So it's been about 12 years since I worked with George. And to come back and to play in the sandbox again is just amazing.
I believe it. And so there are a lot of characters and ships and objects that we've seen before, but now we're seeing them 30 years later. We're seeing both in the movies and in real life. We're seeing them in a different way on different locations. How do you approach something like that? How do you take a ship that we've seen 100 times before and refine it?
Well, I mean, I think that what we were mostly thinking about is, well, what how do you evolve something 30 years into the future in technology? What's happened since 1983 in our technology?
Yeah.
You know, and you kind of look at it that way, and maybe things have gotten sleeker and smoother, and you know, things have gotten smaller.
Yeah.
And, you know, more compact.
Not as many giant blinking buttons and
yeah.
big mechanical switches
yeah.
anymore,
but,
right?
But we just like in our world, we still have old cars driving down the street
yeah.
because people like them. You know, there's always room for that still, even in Star Wars universe.
Well, and I think that's something that's always been wonderful about the Star Wars design sense, right? Is when you see that speeder going across that big wide shot in the beginning of the trailer, you know this is an old speeder.
Yeah.
You know this is a used secondhand speeder.
Exactly.
And I think that's really, really cool.
Yeah.
How do you decide who gets new things, who gets old things? Like, is it looking at the character and just being like, oh, that guy can't have anything new. That guy's got to have rusty stuff. Like, how do you do that?
No, a lot of it is character driven. So that, you know, we get a short brief on what the character is. And so then we design the elements around that based on that. Because everything that we do, that Christian and I do, it's to help support the characters, help support the story.
Yeah.
And so it all has to fit.
Cool. And, you know, how much of a role does audience expectation play into all this, right? Because you're talking about like, well, it's got to be based on the characters and it's got to be based on this world, but like, man, sometimes I'm going to sit down in a movie and I'm going to be completely geeking out because I love the franchise, and I'm going to be like, I don't think it should look like that.
Yeah.
I kind of feel like you're not going to find really bigger fans than like Doug and I.
Yeah.
And if we're happy with it, if the Star Wars 5-year-old in me is happy with it, then I think for that's a good sort of barometer.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're our harshest critics.
We're the harshest critics.
Yeah. Another thing that I wonder about is, okay, you know, in a lot of other movies, you're designing for the movie, right? You're like, okay, well, this is this world that's going to be in this movie. But for Star Wars, you're thinking, well, I have to design this for this movie, but it's probably also going to appear, like, maybe in a TV show down the line. It's got to be a toy. It's got to be in a video game. Does that change the way you approach something?
No, not really. I mean, a strong design, well, it should play through all those media. And so when we design, it's really, I mean, first and foremost, the service of the story that we're working on for the film. And then we have sort of spin-offs in terms of whether or not it can actually play in the theme park or in a toy or in a video game, then that's bonus for us. But we actually just try to go for the best design.
Very cool. So, Christian, this is the first time ILM has looked at fan portfolios at Celebration.
Yes.
And I mean, and there are a lot of wonderful artists within the Star Wars fan community.
Yeah.
What advice would you give to somebody who's going to put a portfolio down in front of you guys or who wants to work for ILM in the future?
Have a diversity of work that's more than just Lucasfilm projects in there. Just because, you know, ILM, we work on everything. We work on, you know, so many different movies, over 300 over the past, you know, almost 40 years now. So I think diversify is great.
Yeah.
And, and show a range of abilities is good. A range of things you can draw. Not, let's say, not just science fiction, sure, fantasy, all that sort of stuff.
Cool. Well, guys, thank you so much for joining us here. We really appreciate you taking time. Remember, we have more here from Star Wars Celebration 2015 live, powered by Verizon for StarWars.com.